Guys, what's up? So this is continuations of core Java program, I mean interview questions and answers, right? So this is the sixth video where we will see some more interview questions and answers for the core Java, right? So before to start, I will show you my playlist. So this is my playlist, guys, because people are getting confused with my playlist. So if you go through my playlist and when you click on here, you can see the different sections. Now for interview sections, I have made one separate playlist. So inside that, you will have all the interview related playlists. Okay, so this is the upper part. Inside that, you will get a lot of playlists, right? So you can study based on your requirement. Now let me start with the core Java part, where today we will study some more questions and answers. So if you look at the last class, we finished till hash table. Today we will start with entry set in the hash map. This is very important, actually, questions you often get in the interview. People will ask you, what does mean by entry set? So basically, when you say entry set in the hash map, you will get a set of entry in the map, right? So when you on the map, when you call this entry set, you will get set of entry in the map. So if you look at the definitions, it is used to return a set view of keys contained in this map, right? So if you look at this example where we are making the object of hash map and we are storing some data, and if you look at the for each loop, so in the for each loop on the reference of hash map HM, when I'm calling entry set, okay, when I'm calling entry set, and the return type of this entry set is map.entry. So basically entry is a class. Entry is a class. Inside that you have a method called entry set. So when you look at this M variable, the type of M is map.entry. Okay, why? Because when you call entry set on map, every entry will be of type map.entry. So this is the reason when we are using for each loop, and when we will store the entry into the variable M, the type is going to be map.entry. So when the for each loop runs, what it will do is it will get entry one by one from that map, and it will store into the M variable. And in the printout statement, if you look at, I am saying that since it is a set of entry, right? So entry has a key and value. So I am doing that m.getKey plus m dot get value, because every entry has a key and value. And if you look at the output down, so it will give you the key also and value also. So if somebody will ask you what does mean by entry set, you can say that it is nothing but set of entry in the map, and basically it is used to iterate over the map, right? That is the use of entry set. Now there is one more example where, let's say you have a class where class has a constructor. The constructor has ID, name, author, publisher, and quantity. So this class has a constructor. The constructor is a parameterized constructor. And here in this example, we are storing the data into the hash map, right? So if you look at the type of map, here is an integer comma A. What does mean by A? A is a class type. So in the map, your key is an integer type, but data is the class type. The class type is nothing but object type. So when we store, we need to store the data of A type, which means object type. So if you look at, I'm creating the object of A, B1 is equal to new A, and inside that I'm storing a data. Why I'm storing 101, test 1, A, B, B, P, and 8? Why? Because in a class, when we have only parameterized constructor, we cannot create the object of default constructor. So we have to create the object of this constructor, and this constructor has int ID, name, author, publisher, and quantity. So similarly, if you look at here, we are creating three objects, and then I am doing that map.put 1, b1, 2, b2, 3, b3, right? So we are putting the data in the map of class type, and then on this map we are calling entry set. So when I say map.entrySet, again you will get map of entry, but here the entry type will change. It will be integer comma A. In the angle bracket, it will be integer comma A. Why integer comma A? Because the keys are type integer and the value of type A. And then when you have when you are running a for each loop inside that, if you look at, I am saying that key is equal to entry dot get key. So when I say key is equal to entry dot get key, you will get a key, and then on that entry, when you say entry dot get value, you will get a value of type A, right? You will get a value of type A because entry is your variable here. So from your entry set, one by one, your entry will get a data. From that entry, you can get a key and you can get a value. Then again, you can say that system output println key is equal to details, like what key, and the value is equal to, if you look at down, I am saying that b.id, b.name, b.author, b.publish and b.quantity. So here the same thing we are trying to do that, but here separately we are storing the key into a variable of type integer and the value into of type object type, because when we were stored, we stored a value of object type. So when you look at the two print statement, we are getting a key and we are getting a value. And if you look at the output, you'll get output like that: 1 details, 101 test 1 AA1 BP8 2 details, 102 test 2, right? So you will get key and then you will get value printed. So you can get 3 key here and the 3 value which will get printed here, right? So entry set is basically, it is used for iterate over a map. I mean, you are actually traversing over a map and you can fetch the data from the map. So this is the usage of entry set. Now the another concept in the map is something called key set. What does mean by key set? So the key set, basically it will give you the list of keys present in the map, right? So if somebody will ask you what does mean by key set, it say that it's a method and basically it is used to get the keys contained in the map. So when you have a hash map and when you have a data in the hash map, and on that map, when you say dot key set, you will get set of key. So when you look at my output, I am getting that 1, 2, 3, because I am calling key set. After calling the key set, I am just trying to print the key set. So you will get all set of keys 1, 2, 3. So this is the use of key set. With this, we are done with the collection framework. I would rather say we are done with the all map, hash table, array list and set. Now another concept, we will start with Java stack. Very important questions. Every time you will get an interview, the people will ask you what does mean by stack. So stack, first of all, it's a LIFO, last in first out, right? So whatever comes last, that item would be the first which will go out of the stack, right? And internally it extends the vector class and it supports 5 operations mainly. Java stack has only one constructor, which is empty or default constructor, right? So whenever you will create an object, you need to create the object of that default constructor. And a stack internally has a pointer, right? Internally has a pointer, and that we call it as a top, which refers to the top of a stack element. So let's say when you are entering the data into the stack, okay, when we are entering the data into the stack, the topmost element of the stack will be referred as top, right? So you can see that one, you know, there will be a top pointer, and if the stack is empty, the top reference to the before first element locations, right? If the top is empty, I mean if there is no data in the stack, then top refers to the before first element location. So it will be like minus 1, top would be minus 1, right? Top would be minus 1, and if a stack is not empty, like a stack has a data, then top refers to the top element of the stack. So when you say get of top in the stack, that would be the top element of the stack. And a stack has mainly 5 methods: empty, pick, pop, push and search. So you can remember these methods, and you can also remember the definition of these methods. People will ask you, it has empty, pick, pop, push and search. So empty, if let's say there is no data in the stack. Pick means it will take the top of the stack data without removing it from the stack. When you say stack dot pick, so it will return you the top of the data without removing from the stack. Pop means it will remove the object from the top of the stack and give you the data. Push means you are trying to insert into the stack. Search means return the one best positions where the object are on this stack, right? So search means you are just trying to search that. Now this is a typical example of a stack where I'm just creating the object of a stack of type integer, and if you look at, I'm trying to push the data, so I'm pushing it 1000, 1000, 2000, 3000, 4000, and in the system output print you can see that a lot of data I'm printing, that I'm saying that non-empty stack, so I'm saying that a stack, just I'm saying that a stack, so non-empty stack, when you say stack, so you'll get no data in the stack, and then pop operation, so I'm saying that stack dot pop, and then non-empty stack after pop operations, and again I'm printing the stack, and then search operation, so I'm searching that 1002, and then I'm looking for stack dot empty. So these are the actions I'm performing on the stack. So if you look at in the main method, in the beginning, when the stack object was created, I'm printing that empty stack stack, and empty stack stack is empty. So stack is empty, I'm calling that method. So if you look at the output also, the first output is empty stack is equal to, it's just a square bracket. The second is true, then third, whatever data you inserted, 1000, 1000, 2000, 3000, 4000, and then pop operation. So when you say pop, you will get 1004 as an output, and after pop operations, if you look at 1000, 1000, 2000, 3000 is the output. Then search operations, it will give you the index of that the data, so you'll get 2, and search dot is empty here, so you are getting that false here. In the beginning it was true, now you are getting a false. So if you remember this much, you can answer any of the questions in the stack. Now let us start with the queue. What does it mean by queue? Queue is FIFO, first in first out, right? First in first out, whatever comes first, that object would be the first to go out. Even it has couple of method, add, offer, remove, pull, element and pick. So if you remember this method, you can answer add, offer, remove, pull, element and pick. Add, again it is used to add. Offer, insert the specified element into the queue. Remove, removes the head of this queue. Pull, retrieve and removes the heads of the queue, or return null if the queue is empty. Element is used to retrieve but does not remove the heads of the queue. Pick, it is used to retrieve but does not remove the head of the of its queue, and return null if the queue is empty. So every, you know, every method has some meaning, so you should understand the meaning also. When you say offer, it is used to insert the specified element into this queue, and when you say add, it is used to insert the specified element into this queue and return true upon success. Okay, so offers means what happens, let's say when you try to basically add into the queue, so it will return the true also, and let's say I think the if the size of the stack is full, right, you will get exceptions, but in case of offer you will not get that, right? In case of offer also does the same job, but you will not get exceptions, but in case of add you will get. Similarly, in case of pull, you will get exception when there is no data. When you are trying to pull it, when there is no data, you will get exception. In case of pick, you will not get the exceptions. Okay, you will not get the exceptions, right? And in case of element, you will get the data, but data will not get removed from the stack, not a stack, sorry, queue. So if you look at with the example, you will understand more. This is the example where we will try to understand more. Here I am using that priority queue. Priority queue internally implements a stack, and a stack is an interface, guys. Sorry, I told wrong, queue. So priority queue internally implements queue, and queue is the interface, guys, whereas a stack is a class. Okay, a stack is a class, queue is a interface. A stack is a class and queue is a interface. So priority queue, when we say internally, it implements a stack interface, queue interface, sorry, not a stack, queue interface. It's my bad guys. So here focus again, I will repeat. Priority queue implements queue. Okay, queue is the interface, whereas the stack is a class. Now when we make the object of priority queue and internally it implements queue, So we can use the method add method. So I'm just adding that, and then I'm saying that q dot element and q dot pick. After that, iterating over, when I iterate, then I'm saying that q dot remove, q dot pull, and after removing two elements, again I'm iterating over, and then we'll see the output. So we'll look at the output. The first head is nothing but test one, and pick is also test one. Okay, head is test one, pick is also test one. Now iterating the q elements, when we are iterating, you will get test 1, test 2, test 3, test 4, test 5, which means none of the data get removed. Which means when you say element and pick, it will not remove the data from the queue. Whereas when you say remove and pull, so remove and pull, it will remove the data from the top. That is the reason if you look at the output. Right, after removal of two elements, again I am iterating over the queue, the data is test 3, test 4 and test 5. Data is test 3, test 4 and test 5. Right, so please try to remember all the methods of queue and stack, and you will be able to answer all the questions in the interview. Okay, thank you guys, thank you for watching this. I will continue with the series, and in the next video, we will start with a string classes, a string buffer and a string builder. Thank you guys, hope this will add value to you, and if you like this video, hit like button and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you once again.